In the series of learning programming in C, today I'm going to talk about language translators. In the previous videos, I have already discussed like what is need of programming, why do you write programs, what is need of programming languages, what are low level programming languages, high level languages, right? Now see, in this video, we are going to discuss language translators. Now, why do we need language translators? What are language translators? See, language of computer is what? Binary language. Computer can only understand zeros and ones. So if you write code in machine language, that is okay. That is zeros and ones form. So computer can directly execute that program. But if you write program in assembly language or high level languages like C, C++, Java, C sharp, JavaScript, then those programs have to be converted into object code. Object code means machine code, zeros and ones, because computer cannot understand assembly language or that high level language, because generally we write program in English language. English means in assembly language, we use what? Mnemonics. Like for addition, we write add, ADD. For subtraction, we write SUB. But computer cannot understand these words, these mnemonics. So you have to convert those mnemonics into machine code, into zeros and ones. And that's exactly language translators do, right? So we are going to discuss all the types of language translators in this video. Now let us discuss language translators. Three translators are there. First is assembler, compiler, interpreter. Assembler is what? It is basically used to convert the program written in assembly language into machine code or object code. Assembler is specifically to convert a program which is written in assembly language, right? And machine code means zeros and ones. So you can say assembler is a computer program which is going to convert the program written in assembly language into machine code or object code, right? Next comes to, for high level languages, for converting high level languages into machine code, two translators are there, compiler and interpreter. So let us see the difference between these two. See, you must have heard about compiler, and you are using compiler also. When you are writing program in C language, you compile that program, then you run that program and you get the output, right? So now let us see the difference. Both are used what? To convert high level language program into machine code. Machine code means zeros and ones form. See, both will convert high level language program into machine code. So what is the difference? Compiler converts it before the execution of the program, and interpreter converts while the program is executing, while the program is running. Now what does that mean? See, suppose you have written a program in C language, right? Then suppose this is a program. You have written this program, and the suppose name is what? First.c. Compiler will take this program, complete one. All the statements written in this program, right? Maybe 10, 100 statements, how many statements are written? All the statements it will take and convert it into object code. Machine code, zeros and ones, right? And after that, linking is done, loading is done, means after that executable file will be created, and then you will run that executable file and you will get the output. That also we'll discuss. See, compiler will work on which model? Translation, linking, loading. Three steps are there. Translation, linking and loading. That we will discuss in next video, the complete process, right? But interpreter act upon interpretation model. Now, what does that mean? See, same program I'm going to take, and what interpreter will do, interpreter will take one statement line by line. It is not going to take the complete code as compilers do. It takes first line, first of all, right? Change it into some intermediate code, and or you can say that object code, and at the same time give you output. At the same time, it will run this statement, you can say, in simple words. It will run the statement, convert it, then run it, statement by statement, right? So while converting, interpreter also takes, you can say, data, if data is required to convert, data is required to run a program. And in this case, it's not like that here only you will give data. No, first the complete program will be converted into object code, exe file. After that, data will be taken to that exe file, and then the program runs. But here it takes line by line, one line, interpret that line, convert it into object code and run it. After that, second line, convert it into object code and run it. Means what? It will convert the code, the high level language code, into object code while the program is running. Means the execution of the program and the conversion and the translation runs parallelly. But here translations done before the execution. It's not a parallel process. That is the main difference. So now what is, so it is what? It is not going to do some linking and loading. But yeah, it will do translation as well as linking and loading. Fine. So now what are some advantages and drawbacks of this thing? I hope you got the process. How compiler works, how interpreter works. See here, directly you will get output. No object code. So one more difference is what? Here object code would be created. Here no object code. No separate file would be created for object code. Next difference is what? It is slower. Why so? Because it is executing line by line. It takes one line, interpret it, means convert it into object code and then run it. Then again take second line, till then CPU will wait, right? Then convert it into object code, then run it. But the time taken by the compiled program, see, it compiled the complete code at one time, right? And then when it is going to execute, so time to execute that compiled code is very less than this time. So you can say interpreter is slower. Means it runs slower than the compiled code. Now next difference is what? See, when you will get errors after compiling the complete code, at last here you will get list of errors or maybe warnings and with line numbers. I hope you are familiar with this thing. But here when you will get errors while running, see, it is taking one line, line by line, statement by statement, and then converting it into object code and then run it. But if any error is there in first line, then it will stop here. At the same time, it will show you error. And so debugging is easy in this case. Finding out errors is easy. But here it is tough because first it will give you list of errors after compiling the complete program. Then it will give you error. So debugging is, you can say, comparatively tougher than this one here in compiler. See, here it's not like that. The object code would be created. It means you would rather say if there is no error in your program, then only it will be successfully compiled and then only it will create object code. If error comes, then you will have to get back to your source code. You will have to correct those errors. Compiler is not going to correct your errors. It just only show you the errors. You will correct, you will modify your program, you will again save it, you will again compile it, and if there is no error, then only it will generate object file, then exe file, and then the program can run, right? Now next difference is what? Once successfully compiled the program, once object code has been created, then after linking and loading, executable file will be created. After that, to run that file, there is no need of this source code. You can directly run that executable file again and again with different different inputs, and obviously according to that input you will get output. No need of the source code. But here you will need source code. Why so? Because here it takes one line only, line by line, statement by statement. It scans the program statement by statement at one time. Means it takes one statement at one time. So it will take this line, interpret it, means convert it into object code and run it. Then again, to run the second statement, obviously interpreter needs this source code, right? So every time it needs source code to run the program. Next difference is what? It generates an intermediate code, or you can say this object code. So it needs more memory to store this code. But here no intermediate code, no object code, separate file for object code has been created, so it requires less memory. Fine, it directly execute the program. You can also take a real life example to see the working of this thing. See, if suppose any Russian delegation come to our country to meet our delegation, like our PM suppose, so, and they speak Russian language only, they don't speak Hindi or English, so our PM is not able to understand Russian. So he needs what? A translator. Whenever they speak like one language, one line in Russian language, the translator will convert that line into Hindi, either Hindi or English. Again, he'll speak second line, and the translator will convert it into Hindi or English, right? And then our PM is able to understand. And when our PM speaks in Hindi, so they are not able to understand because their language is Russian. So their translator will convert whatever our PM say line by line to Russian language. So that is what, it's a kind of interpreter, right? Line by line. But second case is what, if suppose you are watching a Russian movie, so they have dubbed that movie suppose, and they have given those subtitles in English language. So whenever you watch that movie, every time no need of conversion from Russian to English, because you have already compiled that language, compiled that movie, you have already subtitles, that English subtitles. So whenever you will watch, you will get those subtitles. No need to convert that movie again and again or line by line. Fine. So that is what you can say example of a compiler. I hope you are able to relate these things. Fine. So next difference is what? The language which use interpreter is what? Or you can say interpreted languages are Python, Ruby, Perl. And compiled languages are what? C, C++, C#, these kind of languages, right? So if you want to show the working of these compiler and interpreter in this diagrammatic form, then you can write what? Here you can write source code, compiler, then object code, or you can say machine code, and then you will get output. I am writing this short form. This is output, this is machine code. And here this is what? Source code, interpreter, and directly you will get output. No object code and machine code would be generated in a separate file, right? And here, as I have already told you, there is no need of compiler, there is no need of source code. Once that object file has been created, right, then linking and loading will be done, and then you can separately run that executable file. So no need of this compiler to be present in memory while executing, while running that program. But here, while executing the program, interpreter needs to be in memory. Why so? Because it takes line by line. The conversion and the running of the program runs parallelly here. So it needs to present in memory at that time, but no need of this compiler in memory while executing the program, right? So I think these are some differences between this compiler and interpreter. I hope you got my point. So that's it for this video. In the next video, we'll see that translation, linking and loading process. How programs, means when you write a C program, then how that program gets executed. We'll see the complete process. So now, I'll see in the next video. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.